Hello, I'm Bob Lagasse, and welcome to another episode of the Freeride Chronicles. Every winter I head north to Canada to experience some of the world's best skiing. Whether it's at a resort or some of the many backcountry operations, one thing's for sure, I always come home with a huge smile on my face. Now for years, my youngest daughter's been asking me when she's old enough to go on a cat skiing trip. Well, it looks like this is the year, as we have a small group of kids on their first mini road trip. Our first stop is Whitewater Ski Resort, so the kids can get their groove on.
The mountains, they're huge. They're just big. They're just humongous.
Yep. That was pretty much the overall response from everyone on the drive up to Whitewater.
I've known some of the kids since kindergarten. I've had really high expectations for this trip, probably because my dad talks about it all the time going on these trips.
I've been hearing about it for a month since we started planning this thing.
Just 2.5 hours north of Spokane, Washington, lies Whitewater Ski Resort. This resort offers up a lot of variety and challenging terrain, making it the perfect stop for the kids to get their shred on.
Another beautiful day here, impeccable groomers, really nice, and a whole nother experience for the kids. Big mountains here, so they got to see a lot of what Canada's about and what the Monashee Mountains are about.
A lot of people here are really good, and the runs are super steep, so that's a lot of fun. The groom runs were awesome because they were so steep and so easy to carve on, and they were just groomed perfectly.
I have never been to Whitewater, but it was a great day today. We had some great sun. The moguls, they were great. They had a little bit of powder on top of them.
Trying to control a bunch of teens in a huge playground like this, now throw a terrain park in the mix, let's talk about sensory overload. These kids played hard and took full advantage of this winter playground. I can tell you, those kids had a great time. Now, not far from here is the town of Rawson, British Columbia, home to Big Red Cats. Now, this family-run cat skiing operation allows kids 12 and older to experience deep powder skiing. So let's go to Big Red Cats. Cats has terrain for everyone, and these kids are taking it all in.
Today we're gonna be doing some cat skiing at Big Red Cats up here in Roslyn, BC. Pretty excited, it's my first time. Should be fun.
Big Red Cats is one of the few cat operations that allows the younger shredders to experience cat skiing.
3, 1.8, 1.8.
It's fantastic. Kids can come out cat skiing with us, 12 and older. Works great. They need to come out with a parent or a guardian, but it's a ton of fun.
Sign on the dotted line, a short training course, and you're ready to roll.
What you're going to do is learn about transceivers right now. Every transceiver is just simply a radio, and it either sends out a signal or you can use it to search for a signal. They're really simple to use.
We can take up to 12 people out in each cat at a time. We do different levels. We do intermediate, advanced, expert, and uber expert. Mostly for the teenagers coming out, they'll start off in the intermediate, advanced, and some in the expert, and they'll come out with a parent, and it works great.
With over 40,000 acres and 500 name runs, it's pretty easy for Kieran and his staff of professional guides to get you on the money.
You know, it's just wonderful to see, you know, them actually, their face sort of light up, but also just when they start to get it, they really, you can see almost that transition where that spark hits their eyes and just the fire, you know, that excitement just comes, and you know, that's what I like to see.
It's great to see these kids push the envelope a little.
It was fun to hit the jumps because when you landed, the landing was so soft and the snow just shot up in your face, and it was awesome.
My first day of cat skiing was really cool. I was a little scared at first, but it turned out to be really fun, and it was really cool to be able to ride in the cat.
I was a little bit intimidated at first, and then once I got here, the excitement just kicked in. I wasn't scared at all.
Big Red Cats has terrain for everyone, and these kids are experiencing it all.
My first day of cat skiing, it was killer. It was so much fun. The last run, it was perfect. We had a lot of trees that we got to go through. It was so much fun. I think that was probably my favorite run of the day.
When we started cat skiing, it was just amazing. I felt so relaxed. Going on a road trip with all my buddies, it was just so much fun. Just going around, hanging out with them, skiing, going in the cat, having a great time out there, just living life.
The cat skiing at Big Red Cats is great, and these kids got to experience a huge day, you know, skiing from 9 till 3:30 in fresh powder, in the sunshine, and you know, the parents loved it too. The best thing about the whole day though was when they got home, they were beat. So all of them were in bed, sound asleep before they even hit the pillow, I believe.
Now I have a feeling this won't be the kids' last cat skiing trip. Don't go far, because when we come back, we're heading north to Revelstoke.
Free Ride Chronicles, brought to you by Rossignol.
Every inch, every minute, every second, we chip away at finding inspiration to reimagine luxury, making the colors of earth and sunset skies into rich interior accents, or putting the beauty of a forest in the palm of your hands. It will take you to another place, wherever you happen to be. Made with pride, crafted with passion. This is the new 2014 Jeep Grand Cherokee. It is the best of what we're made of.
The snow has never been better up at Mount Spokane.
Let's go!
Come on!
With over 1,400 acres of fast cruiser corduroy runs to steep and deep tree skiing, including the $69 Learn to Ski and Ride Special, which is lift ticket, rental, and lessons, Mount Spokane has got it all. And it's only a gallon of gas away.
More snow!
Let's go!
Come out and play!
You can even tube at the top or enjoy some great night skiing. It's time to play in your own backyard now up at Mount Spokane.
Freeride Chronicles, brought to you by Jeep.
It was great to have the kids along. Now it's time for a little fun with the big kids. We're heading further north to the old railroad town of Revelstoke, British Columbia, which is now home to one of the world's newest destination ski resorts, Revelstoke Mountain Resort. Nestled in between the Selkirks, Monashies, and Purcell Mountains lies Revelstoke Mountain Resort.
Revelstoke's really fortunate for where we are. We have the Columbia River that brings up some warm, moist air from the Pacific. And then we have the Purcell Mountains just to the north of us that captures a lot of the cold air coming down from the Arctic. So it's one of those really rare occasions that you get the warm wet mixed with the cold from the north, and it dumps a huge amount of snow on us.
Huge is right, like 40 to 60 feet of snow annually. And if you're looking for a place to bring the whole family, Revelstoke Mountain Resort is it.
It's really an adventure when you do come here, whether you're a beginner coming to a place like this and you get to learn in a place that's not necessarily a parking lot and has the big mountain environment and all the activities that go along with that, or you're an expert that wants to go ride terrain that the Free World Tour rides on, you've got every option in between.
With over 5,600 feet of vertical and 3,100 skiable acres, now throw in several high-speed lifts, a magic carpet, and a gondola system, you can see it's pretty easy to access the goods at RMR. If you're looking for some leg-burning runs, try skiing from the top of RMR to the base. This will get the legs pumping, and it's definitely the place to let it all hang out.
Football field wide is what you normally get, and a lot of natural contour to them, although they're groomed really nice and well each morning. If you're just looking to put the pedal to the metal and open it up, then certainly you have that ability.
I like to go fast, probably because it just feels like you're almost flying, and when you hit moguls, it's almost like you're just hitting jumps and you're basically just flying.
If you're looking for a little more adventure, Revelstoke Mountain Resort is the only resort worldwide to offer lift, cat, heli, and backcountry skiing, all from one village base. Now, if you want that over-the-top powder experience, make sure you book a day out with Selkirk Tangiers Heli Skiing. Whether it's a one-day or seven-day trip, Selkirk Tangiers will leave you wanting more.
So Revelstoke definitely has this reputation for being big, bad Revelstoke. And what we want people to know is that certainly we have that, but we've been adding to that experience by, you know, 47.5% of our terrain is geared towards intermediates. We've built this beautiful new beginner area. And what we've done is we've taken the world's greatest big, bad Revelstoke idea and added all the friendliness that a family could come to as well. So that whole experience is in on us now.
After all, you have all the amenities like ski-in and ski-out luxury condominium-style lodging at the Sutton. With 222 rooms and a beautifully appointed lobby, you'll never want to leave. The base has several dining choices.
We've got a great restaurant in the Rockford which serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner, as well as it's a bar setting, so it's casual dining, but certainly great food on the walk, bar, and grill style of food. We have a great coffee shop called La Baguette where you could get French-style pastries and exquisite coffees from around the world. Revelstoke's one of the older cities in British Columbia, and they've had full service there for quite some time. We're about 6 to 10 minutes, depending on the day, from town, so it's a quick jaunt into town with lots of history, great food, great services, and a nice atmosphere for nightlife as well.
It's all about the overall experience at Revelstoke Mountain Resort. With plenty of choices, RMR has something for everyone. Now don't go far, because when we come back, we're heading east into the Rockies.
Free Ride Chronicles, brought to you by Obermeyer. Freeride Chronicles, brought to you by Swanee Gloves.
As you can see, Revelstoke has a lot to offer. Now, just a few hours east of Revelstoke is the picturesque ski resort of Lake Louise. If the skiing doesn't blow you away, then the scenery definitely will.
There's lots of things that make Lake Louise fantastic. It truly is one of the most beautiful ski areas in the world. There's lots of different forces of Mother Nature's been in play, but one of the big things is glacier. And they really went and carved out these mountains. They're very rugged, very dramatic. It helps create some expert terrain. The glaciers have left their mark, and they're beauty to behold.
Beautiful is an understatement. Nestled in the rugged Canadian Rockies, Lake Louise is only 2 hours west of Calgary and only 4 hours north of Spokane, Washington. With over 140 runs and 4,200 skiable acres, Lake Louise Resort is the largest ski resort in the Canadian Rockies, and it has terrain for all abilities.
If you're a beginner, there's nice gentle runs, and if you're an expert and you want to ski the double black diamond or anything like that, it truly provides, as a skier or snowboarder, the best challenge you'll find anywhere.
Look behind me, the scenery is absolutely jaw-dropping. The skiing here is unbelievable. I think those two make it an unbeatable combination. The vertical is kind of leg-crushing. The 3400 here, I mean, you do 8 or 10 runs before noon here, you're going to have a full day.
With four mountain faces, you can always find great snow and conditions throughout the ski year.
Never thought I'd be skiing powder at the end of April with a bluebird skies, but it was awesome. It was perfect.
With easy access, great terrain, and plenty of snow, you need to put Lake Louise on your hit list.
And honestly, Lake Louise, when it comes to being a skier's mountain, is it. It has everything that you want, from crazy steeps, huge cornices, wide open groomers. If you love skiing, you love snowboarding, I promise you, you will find terrain that you're going to fall in love with at Lake Louise.
25 years ago, a cat skiing operation opened up its doors just outside of Fernie, British Columbia. And over the years, this operation keeps setting the standards higher with their service. Welcome to Island Lake Lodge. Island Lake roots go deep, starting back in the 80s, when skiing and boarding icons Scott Schmidt and Craig Kelly started spending much of their winter embedded here in the Lizard Mountain Range, and eventually they became partial owners of Island Lake. With abundant snowfall and a 7,000 acre backyard, it's no wonder they were drawn here.
Yeah, it's a very unique microclimate. We get about 12 meters of snow on average, 14 meters last winter. We have a very special ecosystem here as well. Giant coastal style trees. Because we've been glading and taking care of the land for about 20 years, there's some great open glades and monster character trees throughout the landscape.
Tree skiing here is off the charts good.
The trees were gladed, they were perfectly spaced. You had a lot of room in there to get creative and fly off some little poppers and have some fun. The old growth forest was so cool. There's huge cedar trees and big larch trees. It was a lot of fun to ski in there.
Just like everything at Island Lake, it's special. Take the cuisine, for example.
We have quite the reputation for our cuisine. So we try to go local, organic whenever possible, and simplified version of high-end cuisine.
Simplified? Yeah, right.
Food is spectacular. I mean, you can't ask for anything more. First night, you sit down, you're just going, really? They're doing this out in the middle of nowhere? Just really, really good.
Island Lake will even share their secrets.
We do have a Canadian best-selling cookbook out. We call it French-inspired Rocky Mountain cuisine.
there's been plenty of additions and improvements over the past 25 years.
Here at Island Lake, we have four lodges. The Bear Lodge was the historical first lodge that was built 25 years ago. And at that time, you stayed in it, you ate in it, and partied in it. And now we primarily use it as a après bar and a ski room downstairs.
With the addition of three beautiful log structure lodges, the Red Eagle has 10 bedrooms, the Tamarack Lodge, 8 deluxe bedrooms, and the Cedar Lodge, which hosts a full dining room, wine library, luxury spa, and 8 deluxe bedrooms. There's plenty of room for everyone to unwind. Now, coming back to the lodge and chilling is brought to a whole new level at Island Lake. Another beauty about Island Lake, it's only a few minutes from Fernie, British Columbia, and it's extremely easy to get to.
Just a few Ks right off the main road to get you in the cat, nice short cat ride, mellow entrance, and all of a sudden you're in the middle of nowhere.
Just the way you want it. Middle of nowhere with your own private powder stash. The terrain in Island Lake is suitable for many levels of riders.
We cater to a variety of skiers and snowboarders. We do suggest that you are a strong intermediate to start with, but we get people from all over the world coming. It's actually a lot easier than people think. We put all our guests on big powder skis, and that increases their ability level in powder a fair bit and makes their day a lot more enjoyable.
If you like to get after it and charge hard, there's plenty of terrain with your name on it.
Skiing's been fantastic. Fun features everywhere. Big old growth trees. It's a really fun place to pick around to the trees. There's some nice wide open glades. It makes it really enjoyable.
And this is coming from a 9-year member of the United States Freestyle Ski Team. Big trees and deep pow means one thing, big smiles. And what better way to celebrate that last run than some good old Canadian hospitality.
Complete without a beer.
Woo-hoo! Whether the food, accommodations, or terrain, everything at Island Lake is over the top.
Chronicles brought to you by Smith Optics.
Have you ever skied in two states at the same resort? You can do that at Lookout Pass, your number one powder place, with some of the best prime powder tree skiing around. With an average annual snowfall of 400 inches, you'll enjoy epic powder days and world-class grooming. Voted the most favorite family-friendly resort and the most affordable rates in the region, our friendly staff makes it fun for the whole family. Go to SkiLookout.com for a complete list of all our events. Your number one powder place, Lookout Pass.
To learn more about Scenic Idaho, go to visitidaho.org.
Thanks for joining us for this episode of the Freeride Chronicles. Make sure you check out all the resorts and operations online and book your next powder trip. If you want to follow Freeride Chronicles, check us out on Facebook. Until next time, I'm Bob Lagasa, and I'll see you on the hill.